Before we are taught anything, we know there is more. And this is the case when considering the Great Pyramid. There is very little doubt left that what we are witnessing at the Giza Plateau is in fact a masterpiece that was created by a civilization that is no longer present here on the Earth. Not only is the Great Pyramid the biggest anomaly in our understanding of the past, it is also the greatest wonder present on the planet today, and one in which we completely do not understand. When this thing was first excavated in the 9th century, nothing was found inside. No treasure, no burial artifacts, nothing. It was bare, abandoned long ago and completely sealed, possibly to contain radiation if it was a power plant before the flood. For something to be sitting in plain sight with no documentation, no hieroglyphics, no apparent purpose as to why it is there, is mind-blowing. Not only was the undertaking of such an industrious feat of engineering impossible for ancient man, but it would appear that it also lacks any fundamental value towards the society that is said to have created it. For us to be told that King Khufu ordered the construction of this thing, for it to be built in such a way that it was never replicated, and for us to then believe this is the case against all the odds, is astonishing. When you consider they would have to have had a constant construction line right round the clock for 25 years, which involved transporting and laying one mega block every 2 minutes, and that was transported 400 miles from Aswan, that is around 30 massive stone blocks per hour or 720 30-ton blocks per day. It's impossible. They tried to use the said method with one of these blocks, and the stone capsized the boat as soon as the crane released the load. So how did they do this 720 times a day? Anyway, this is what they are categorically telling us to be true. It's a joke. Today we are going to talk about two inscriptions found at the Great Pyramid, so wait till you hear this. Let us tell you something. For the level of sophistication we see at Giza, and in particular the Great Pyramid, you would need a society that were highly advanced in mathematics. You would need to understand the Earth's landmass and our position in the solar system. The secrets contained at Giza are literally out of this world, and although there are no directives or explanations at the Great Pyramid, there could be secrets contained in its measurements for humanity's advancements. An example of this being the placing of the structure on the Earth. The coordinates for the Great Pyramid are the same digits for how fast you would need to travel to be traveling at the speed of light. The alignment of this thing at this very location on this planet is no doubt deliberate, and there simply must be advanced secrets to our future hidden in advanced disciplines of teaching that we are yet to discover. Consider the original grand entrance to the wonder. Could it be that the structure we see today is in fact the outer jacket of a much more ancient structure? Now, there are no hieroglyphics with the exception of a cartouche with Khufu's seal on it. This single piece of documentary evidence is why they say it was built by Pharaoh to house Pharaoh after death. And guess what? This is widely accepted to be an elaborate hoax set in place by Richard Weiss. The inscription, which incredibly reads "The Gang of Khufu," was found in 1837 by Sir Richard Weiss, a British soldier and adventurer who used gunpowder to blast his way into the inner chambers of the Great Pyramid. At the time, it was believed to have been left there by the pyramid's builders. Sir Richard's critics asserted the cartouche was a forgery by the rough and ready adventurer in order to justify yet more evidence in his treasure hunting schemes. But professor of ancient Egyptian civilization at Cairo University, Ahmad says, there is now plenty of evidence to support the age of the cartouche, and it's not from the reign of Pharaoh Khufu. Professor Said says the cartouche contains the king's short name and not the full official version as is used during a pharaoh's reign. So you see, the Great Pyramid was wrongly credited as being a tomb. In fact, no mummified remains have ever been found at any pyramid at all. Nowhere does it say these elaborate structures are tombs. And in fact, we even have the place where kings and queens were entombed at the Valley of the Kings. So why are they still telling us this to be true when it is categorically dreamed up? The fact of the matter is they don't know what the Great Pyramid is. Nobody knows. The only clear option shared by researchers is that it is an industrious wonder, the true age of which could be staggering and maybe even beyond our comprehension. Now, what if we were to tell you that in 2006, a group of German researchers accessed and defaced Weiss's cartouche? They took the samples back to Dresden in Germany, where tests were carried out on the dating of the red paint of the cartouche. The results? You guessed it, guys. It dated to the 19th century and is more than likely an elaborate hoax by Richard Weiss. The German researchers were prosecuted by both the German and Egyptian authorities for uncovering this truth, and there is actively a block to withhold this information. Egypt set up a heritage task force to counter the claims, accusing the Germans of defacing a world monument. Above the main entrance of the Great Pyramid, four massive relieving stones divert the immense weight piled above the entry passage. Linear geometric patterns formed by joints in the stonework reference the Paleo-Sanskrit glyphs, karas karas, meaning workings, workings, while the triangular cavity below the giant blocks corresponds to the glyph for upama, meaning the highest. These bold geometric architectural features together present a votive passage that was used at aligned sacred sites throughout the world to signify the deep infrasonic resonance of the pyramid structures that powered the global civilization. The glyphs embedded in the Great Pyramid's entry facade read, "Workings of the Highest," the only ancient inscription found. It is probably credible to note of the fact that the Great Pyramid niche inscription bears a close resemblance to glyphs embossed on metal debris from the 1947 Roswell, New Mexico Viamana disc crash and also the Rendlesham Forest incident. The Roswell debris texts were first translated in 2007 by applying the Schindelman cipher. It would seem that this decipher has disappeared from publication since the author's death. But what does this type of inscription mean? There is little doubt that the world was connected in ways we don't understand today in the past. We see similarities in building techniques that can only be explained if there was contact between cultures in the past, and indeed, they very well may have all been connected prior to the Great Flood. For example, could it be possible that the ancient Hindus had a part to play in the construction at Giza, using their Viamana to transfer the huge blocks? This is just as feasible as any other theory out there and adds weight to the argument that there was advanced technology in this region in the very distant past. Indian history is dating back to the time of the gods, just like the Egyptians does, and equally has tales that are so unbelievable that they are simply classed as myths, so maybe there is some argument at least to such a theory. Indeed, such a global civilization could be referencing an Atlantean culture. Maybe, guys, just maybe. The feeling that everything was once connected is strong. We can theorize on how the water separated the lands and contact was lost. Today we are left with the debris of the ancients and the clear picture that on this earth, in the ancient past, there was an advanced civilization that were capable of incredible feats of engineering that is almost beyond comprehension. The question then must be this: why are we actively being lied to as a civilization? Who the hell is calling the shots, and why are we believing all the lies? The builders of the pyramids were not fools. They have left clear-cut proof that can't be destroyed, and guess what? We are no longer ignoring this either. We will leave it at that for the moment, guys. You can let us know what you think of these texts in the Great Pyramid, because any ideas you may have towards it are probably closer to the truth compared to what they are teaching us today. We may not have the answers, but at least we do have the questions. comments below, and as always, thank you for watching.